Okay, can we just have half an hour for discussion? And this diagram, according to Vygotsky, represents two different lines of development. There are two types of mediating activity. Not only one, two types. First is mastering of tools of labor, and the second, mastering of mental tools, which is signs, symbols, and cultural signs. It means that tools and signs are of different nature. Because he says this very clearly. Substantial difference of the sign from the tool and the basis for the real divergence of these two lines is the different purpose of one and another. Is it clear? So, and there is one gentleman who introduces the point of artifact and saying that every activity is mediated by artifacts. And people are closing, wow, artifacts. But what is artifact? Artifact is the mixture between the artifact might be the tools of labor, language, signs, symbols, instruments. Yeah. How you can combine those two divergent lines into one? Who makes this, combining these two lines into one concept of artifact, really destroys the whole approach? Because he says that there are divergent lines, two lines which cannot be clicked by using some unified concept. Okay? Boom. And that was the second point, as you understand, yeah? Mediated and negated. And the last point is that again, because he said that we have to analyze the process of sign occurrence. So the sign arises as a result of complex process of development. From the transition from the situation of non-sign, when there are no signs, to the signs mastery. Yeah? The sign is the result. And we need to concentrate not on the product, but on the process, because he said it means that we should concentrate on the transition from the stage when there is no sign yet, to the stage when the sign appears, and then the person begins to master these signs as it. And those who are analyzing mediative activity, they really analyze the products, the results. Yeah? Because mediative activity is past indefinite tense, which is already mediated. And this is a result of development. But because he says that the result of development, we cannot, but we should concentrate on the process which brings the result.
Okay, result, an example would be a plan, but it's the getting to the plan.
Yeah, good.
Nikolai?
Huh?
Can you tell me what you mean by sign?
Because you mean a special, specially created stimuli, like double stimulation, created artificially, just to solve some task. For example, I give you an example from the experiment. So, it was an experiment of the development of memory in child. So the child was placed in the room, and there were some objects, like pieces of paper, like some parts and sticks and so on. And during the play, it was a task for the child to remember something. But the task was quite hard for him. What it was about is with his abilities to remember. And then the experimenter was just giving some hints to him. And then the child begins to use those natural objects as a reminder for him. Okay, if you remember this big number, just take a piece of paper, divide it into parts, and then you can. Okay? So the child is trying to use neutral objects as tools to organize this process of remembering. So, and in this case, this is a paper now science working.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And but this is one example, but there are a lot of examples that you can find many of them from questions. Yeah, but this is because the science are artificially created things which help to solve the task of to remember or to make something which Jacques is not able to do using his biological resources.
Is this to represent
date? Yeah, maybe. Mm-hmm. Well, so and my message is that to be Vygotskian means not to analyze the results, the products, because products are the products. Well, the idea is to restore the whole process which brings these results. And then you will understand why these results are these results, but not the other results. Yeah? What was behind, what bring this result? It's again I'm using this this metaphor with the apple. If you want to understand what really apple is, of course you can take the apple from the tree, you can then test the apple, you can put it on the microscope, you can analyze the apple whatsoever. But if you really want to understand what apple is, you should understand how it appears. So the tree, and then the waves, and then the leaf, and then the vines, and fruit as a result of the whole. So then you will have an idea what apple is, really is. Yeah? And any fruit, like apple, using the wheel of generalization, they might look differently, but they're using all our fruits, it means that they are coming from all these stages. Yeah? Huh? Mm-hmm. So, and the last is the sign, when the sign appears, it begins to reorganize the whole system of the functions. And therefore, the role of sign is important. The mediation is important only when we look at mediation as to the process, but not to the as to the result. You understand? Do you understand what I mean? So if you look on mediation as to mediating activity, but not as a mediated activity, if you look on the sign not as a product, but as a result of the process of development. And you are again trying to write down, but well, it's the slide is of the screen should be. Well, and then the results of development. The results of development should not be just new functions. And again, it's a mistake because for many people, they describe the new formations or neo formations, the results of development as some new function or new ability of the child, including many great psychologists who said that there's a new function like active thinking should appear at the elementary school. But the Vygotskian approach was that neoformation is not the like something new. Neoformation is the reorganization of the whole system. Yeah, new type of organization, this is the result. If you do experiment, if you have no such result, so... Okay, now I go to the last point of the first part, but well, I have really no time for the second one. Well, the general genetic law of cultural development, and my question is, am I right when I say that if you do not understand the general law of the theory, it means that you do not understand the theory? Can I say like this? Yeah? Can I say that if you understand the general law of the theory, it seems that you probably understand the whole theory. Okay, this is the formulation of the general law of development. Every Vygotskian knows it by heart. I mean the car. Any function in child development appears in stage twice and so on and so on. Yeah? You just read it because of it. I think it's familiar for and what is here on this is that in modern society, the book that I mentioned once during this conference, The Mind Society gives us this translation, this one. And we see there are two different translations of the same law. And can you find any differences between these two translations? Or are they more or less okay? More or less the same? Yeah? They are slightly different from each other, but they reflect the core message correctly, right? So it speaks about the pure spice, and this speaks about the pure spice on the social level, on the internal level, it's okay. But what is interesting is that many people are writing their papers about, and they're quoting, not the original negotiation, but they're quoting the from the Mind and Society. It's very strange because after Mind and Society, this was also published in volume number 4. But people are still quoting this translation from Mind and Society, which is very strange, which is the older one.
But
if you send your paper to the journal, they say that you should quote the newest literature. But in this case, nobody cares.
But is the nuance, as in 1983, is that the original from Vygotsky?
Yeah, it's the original, but it's the same in 1997, volume 4, Lenin Press. And see, the first point is that, according to Vygotsky, fundamental function doesn't appear in social relations. It's a wrong understanding. Fundamental function never appears in social relations, and then disappears and appears again inside. How very strange. That's what they really call it. No. Fundamental function is a social relation itself. Fundamental function is not in social relation. Fundamental function is social relation between the two people. Yeah, this is the first point. Look here. Every fundamental function before becoming internal was a social relation between the two. Social relation is not the area, it's not the place. Social relation is exactly the fundamental function. And of course it doesn't mean that every social relation is going to be a fundamental function if you like. Of course, yeah? So it means that fundamental function has to be a special kind of social relation which is different from what is the social relations we have. And because he says absolutely clear about what kind of social relation it is. Look here, again. Firstly, it appears among people as interpsychological category. Then, within the child as interpsychological category. But what is category then? Huh? Oh, sorry. Boom, this is the answer. The category is dramatical collision between two people, dramatical event, full of emotions, entities, mind. This is the first form in which fundamental function appears as a social relation of me and somebody else, dramatical collision full of emotions and visuality. And then it appears in Sunday, because in the morning I remember that event, I'm repeating again for me. And if I was wrong, when I was wrong, yesterday talking to you guys, and in the morning I had very, very deep visuality that I said, words to you. And I said to me, well, never do this again, Nikolai, because it's so nice, so great person. And just made it sort of deep pain for him. And so what is going on? It appears second time. It appears twice. Now second time. It has interpsychological category. I'm repeating the same event, the same category. And it makes it different. It brings the changes to my account.
The picture that comes to mind,
yeah,
with the dramatical collision between two people is cars.
Yeah, but that's exactly, because it's a Greek word. It means something like accuse,
yeah,
and have an argument.
Yes, yeah.
So
okay.
And I don't want to tell you the story why I think this, because well, it was only one story that, of course, I found the answer from some sources, but it's another story. But well, what I want to tell you is that first high level function was a social function, social relation, and second it was a social relation of certain type called category, which literally from theater means collision dramatically as a unit of drama. No, please. He will have time now, okay, for discussion. Because I want to... And for here, we must be right. For here, it comes the first requirement to experiment. Look, the first requirement for conducting experiment is that in experiment should begin from the first appearance of higher mental function. Experiment should begin from the dramatical collision. Otherwise, it is not Vygotskian experiment. Otherwise, it is not genetical experiment. Otherwise, it is not genetical experimental method. So, everybody who is doing experiment is with no dramatical collision in the beginning. Just pretending to play Vygotskian play, but it's not. So, and then I logically come to the second part. Very quickly. Genetic method. Now you will understand absolutely everything because there are five principles and all those principles are the results of what we discussed now. Look. The first principle is the principle of bounds of development. If the task is to restore the whole process of development, yeah? And this is the only task of the Vygotskian experiment. So we should start from the beginning. We should find the functions who are not developed yet, who are now ready to be developed in the embryonic stage, and then we should. Yeah? Because if you are working with the functions which are already developed, it's not possible. We should restore from the bud to the apple. But if you have an apple, you just eat an apple, that's it.
So bud.
This is bud.
Bud.
Bud. Bud. Bud. Zavis.
Kupochka.
Kupochka, да. Okay? So. This principle means that at the beginning, the experimental study should be detecting the function which are in the bud, embryonic stages, but not already developed. So, doesn't make any sense to develop which is already developed.
No.
Okay? The principle of the category. This is the second one. Because according to the general genetic law, which is general law, not to be neglected during the experiment. If you do an experiment which neglects the law, it is not an experiment, it's just a farm. For granted, nothing else. We should begin the experimental study for specially created collision, the category, the dramatical event, somehow using narrative, using fairy tales, using whatsoever, using what Milday is using in her interviews. So, but if there is no clearly detected collision, so there is no starting point. The principle of interaction of the real material form, experimental study, should be arranged, should be shaped and designed in such a way that from the very beginning up to the very end, the ideal form should interact with the real form. Because this is the requirement of the theory. If you neglect this, you will never have a correct tool to understand this aspect of the development, and your experimental data will be dirty data, not valid. And this collision should be artificially created. And the Giovannia is very good indicator of the child involvement, so of interaction to the ideal form. If child is neutral, if nothing is touching him, so he's not involved. And Thierry Giovanni is very good concept in the sense that it can be used also as a good practical indicator of the child's reaction and involvement in the process of development. So the principle of developmental tools, which is coming from the mediation principle, right? In every step of experiment, we should be able to give to the child a number of different tools, as in my example, the objects, the different objects which can be turned into the status of tools and signs. And an experiment should somehow describe the process of the transition from non-use tool to tool using, from non-mastering to mastering of the tool, because only sign reorganizes, do you remember quotation? The appearance of sign reorganizes the whole system. If there is no sign, there will be no reorganization. If you want to have qualitative changes, please give the sign to the child or create the sign together with the child. Otherwise, you will never have the results. You will never have the development results. And your experiment